What's the first thing you do when you start feeling sick? If you're like most of us, you probably reach for something full of good old vitamin C. Whether you're drinking it from a carton, popping it from a bottle, or getting it straight from the source, vitamin C's purported power to cure what ails you is virtually unmatched in the popular consciousness. And a lot of that is because of a guy named Linus Pauling and his landmark work on the effects of vitamin C. There's just one problem. Linus was probably, totally, tragically, wrong. You might not have ever heard of him, but Linus Pauling was a brilliant chemist. When he was in his 20s, he became world famous for his success in applying quantum physics to molecular structures. Later, his work launched an entirely new branch of science, and he helped inspire Watson and Crick's discovery of the structure of DNA. He won Nobel Prizes for both chemistry and peace, and he is the only person to ever win two unshared Nobels. His scientific career was one of remarkable success after remarkable success. But if you asked Pauling, he might have told you that his most important work came later in life when he began studying vitamin C. Specifically, his work centered around the role of antioxidants in your body. Antioxidants can be found in lots of fruits and vegetables. And in your body, they act like little janitors, cleaning up your system of so-called free radicals, which are basically evil little molecules that damage your DNA and cell membranes. Studies have shown that people who eat fruits and vegetables high in antioxidants live longer and have lower rates of cancer and heart disease. And so the logic follows that if people who eat more antioxidant-rich foods are healthier, then taking antioxidant-rich supplements like vitamin C should make you even healthier. So in his book, Vitamin C and the Common Cold, Pauling urged everyone to take 3,000 milligrams of vitamin C a day to maximize its effects. That's 50 times the recommended daily dose. The book became an instant bestseller, and vitamin C sales doubled, tripled, and quadrupled. Drugstores couldn't even keep it in stock. But Pauling was just warming up. He went on to claim that vitamin C, used together with other vitamins, could cure just about any human ailment. Heart disease, the flu, strokes, rabies, snake bites, cancer, you name it. When AIDS came to the United States in the 1970s, Pauling claimed that vitamins could treat that too. Driven in part by his advocacy, vitamin C became the most widely used vitamin supplement in the United States by the 1980s. But even as Pauling was growing increasingly enthusiastic about the possibilities for vitamin C, his colleagues in the scientific community were not.
Professor Pauling is a great chemist, but he's not a physician, he's not a nutritionist, and I don't think he really knows much about what he's talking or writing about.
Studies on vitamin C had actually been around for decades before Pauling started his work, and they all pointed to similar conclusions, that vitamin C had little or no impact on the severity or duration of colds, much less cancer. In fact, in recent years, studies have even suggested that people who take antioxidant-rich supplements like vitamin C might be at a higher risk of dying from cancer than those who don't. How could that be? Well, no one knows for sure, but the most likely explanation is that even though free radicals attack cells in your body, they also protect your body by killing harmful bacteria and new cancer cells. So taking unnaturally high doses of antioxidants might actually be tipping the balance too far in one direction, leading to what scientists call the antioxidant paradox. This research wasn't available to Pauling at the time, but it may not have really mattered. Despite all the criticism, he continued to defend the health benefits of high doses of vitamin C for the rest of his life. In a 1990 interview, he said that people who take vitamin C and other supplements in the optimum amount could live 25 to 35 years longer. More than that, he said, they will be free of diseases. Then, 4 years later, he died of prostate cancer. Pauling's scientific legacy lives on. He was a brilliant scientist with staggering achievements to his name, and no one can take that from him. But he also left a dubious legacy surrounding the powers of vitamin C. And that legacy today has given rise to a billion-dollar industry that shows no signs of slowing down. Even though it's probably, totally, tragically, wrong. Subscribe to our show page and be the first to see new episodes of Wrong.